गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी स्टडी द अलोहा प्रोटोकॉल फॉर द मल्टीप्लेक्सेस। द मीन ऑफ द मल्टीप्लेक्सेस इज दैट वी हैव वन शेयर्ड चैनल्स। हाउ द मल्टीपल यूजर विल एक्सेस द शेयर चैनल इन सच ए वे दैट देर आर मिनिमम चांसेस फॉर द फ्रेम क्लोजर्स। सो एज वी नो दैट फॉर हैंडलिंग ऑफ द मल्टीप्लेक्सेस दिस इज द रोल ऑफ द डाटा लिंक लेयर्स। So here we study the data link layer. In the data link layer, we have the two sub layer that is known as the data link control, that is also known as the logical link control, which is concerned with the flow control as well as the error control. Second layer is known, sub layer is known as the multiple access resolution. It's also known as the MAC layer. This layer is used for the framing, addressing as well as the multiple access controls. So today we will study how we have to control the multiple access in such a way that the probability of the occurrence of the frame collision is minimum. So here we discuss the classification of the multiple access protocols. So uniformly we will classify the multiplex protocol in three categories. First is the random access protocol, second is the controlled access protocol, third is the channelization protocols. So under the random access protocols, we have the Aloha. So in the today lecture, we will study, give the focus on the how the Aloha protocol will work. Second is the CSMA. CSMA stand for the carrier sense multiple access. CSMA CD stand for the carrier sense multiple access collision detection. This protocol is used for the wired networks. CSMA CA, that is the carrier sense multiple access collision avoidance, that we use in the wireless networks. So what do you mean by random access? In the random access or the contention method, no station is superior to the another station and none is assigned the control of over the another. So no station permit or does not permit another station to send at any each instance. A station that has a data to send use a procedure defined by protocol to make a decision on whether or not to send the data. So topic under this section, we will discuss the two variant of the Aloha protocols. One is the pure Aloha protocol, second is the slotted Aloha protocols. So in the pure Aloha protocols, here we have a given that we are the four stations and they are sending the frames. So in the pure Aloha, the protocol is that when a station have a frame, it can send the frames. So here we finding that while the station 1 is sending the two frame, frame number 1.1 and the frame number 1.2, and the station 2 is again sending the two frame, frame number 2.1 and the frame number 2.2. Similar station number 3 will send the frame number 3.1 and the frame number 3.2. Similar station 4 will sending the frame number 4.1 and the frame number 4.2. So here we are finding that the frame number 1.2 and the 2.1 and 3.1 and 4.1, they are colliding at the middle. So there is a collision will occur in the these frames. In the frame 1.1, it is only sent at that frame, so there is no collision will be occur at the this frame. Frame number 2.2 and the 4.2 is again colliding, and the frame number 3.2, it does not having any collision. So here we are finding that if we use the protocols, that if a station have a frame, it will send the frame, there is lot of chances, lot of probability of the collision in the frames. So procedure that will adopt in the pure Aloha. So we'll start means if a station have a frame, it frame to send, then we use some attribute. One attribute is k refer the number of attempts that a sender using for sending the frames, and we have another variable k max is the maximum number of time a station will perform the attempt to send the frames. Second is the TP is the maximum propagation time. Maximum propagation time is that it is the worst case time that a frame will take while we are sending the data from the first station to the last stations. Next is the TFR. TFR is the average transmission time for a frame. TB is the back of time. So how the pure Aloha will be work? wheel start means, start means if a station having a frame, it will use the counter, that is k equal to 0, it will send the frame. Next is, when a station will send the frame, it will wait time mode, time is 2 into TP. TP is the propagation time, it is the worst case time that will send a frame from the station 1 to the last stations. So, we are waiting, our wait out time is 2 into TP. 2 into TP means one time we will take for sending the frame, and second TP time will wait to get the acknowledgement whether the station will receive the frame successfully or no. So that's why we have our wait out time is 2 into TP. So after the 2 TP time, if we get the acknowledgement, it means the frame is successfully received by the receiver or the receiver stations. If the acknowledgement is not receiver, we will increment the value of k by 1s. Then we will compare the value of k by the k max. The value of k max is 15, means each and every station is given to maximum 15 attempt to send the frame. If it reached more than the k, if the k reached the more than the k max, it will abort the process, means it will stop some time to sending the data. Otherwise, if no, it will choose a one random number. The value of the random number lie between 0 to 2 the power of k minus 1. If I say the value of k is 3, it means the value of the r is 0 to 7. So we will choose a random number among the 0 to 7, and we will wait, that is the TB, that is the backup time. So we want here that the backup time r should be equal to r into TP. The purpose of the here backup time is that we are making here randomness, that each and every station, if there is a closure will be occur, it will wait a random amount of time. The purpose for the here the random amount of time is that, again, if we say that each and every station will start by sending the frame after a fixed amount of time, then the frame again collides. So what we are doing, that we are here assuming that, or doing that, the frame, the station will wait a random amount of time before it again send the frame. So this process will be continue, and the so in the pure Aloha, this procedure we will follow in the pure Aloha. And in the pure Aloha, we here get the efficiency. Efficiency is that number of frame successfully sent by, received by the receiver, divided by the number of frames sent by the sender. So here we are finding in the pure Aloha that maximum efficiency is 18%. It means receiver will receive maximum 80 frames without any collusion out of 100 frames. Next is the slotted Aloha, which is the advanced version of the pure Aloha. In the slotted Aloha, what we will do that, as we find in the pure Aloha, that frame starting of the some frame will be collided by the end of the some frames. So what we want, that we do not want that start of any frame and the last of any frame will be collide in between the sending. So what we will do, we will divide the sending of the frame by the slots. So each and every station will send the frame while the slot will start. So in between the slot, no station will be allowed to send the frame. So here we are finding that while the slot number 1, only the station 1 will send the frame number 1.1, and no other station will send the frame. So and here we are finding that frame 1.1 is not collided to with any frames. Second, in the slot 2, we are finding that frame number 2.1 and the frame number 3.1 is sent by the station 2 and the 3, and it will collide initially. So again we finding that frame number 1.2 and 4.1 is collide, frame number 2.2 is collide, 4.2 and 3.2 is does not collides. So slotted Aloha is the better variant as compared to the pure Aloha, in which we have achieved the maximum efficiency as compared to the pure Aloha. And the maximum efficiency we will achieve in the slotted Aloha is 37%, approximate 37%. So next is the vulnerable time in the slotted Loha. Again, we are finding that vulnerable time in the slotted Loha is, that is the TFR. TFR is the average frame sending time. So here in the slotted Loha, we will reduce the vulnerable time. Vulnerable time is that time in the which probability of the collision will be occur when more than one station send the frames. So here the vulnerable time in the slotted Loha is TFR. That is the half of the pure Loha. Thank you. For this lecture, we follow the book Data Communication and Networking by the Frozen.